हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक. सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू क्लास 12th हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 4 थिंकर बिलीव्स एंड बिल्डिंग्स एंड पार्ट 2. सो इन दिस चैप्टर फर्स्टली वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द जैनिज्म एंड द बुद्धिज्म. सो हियर यू कैन सी द पिक्चर ऑफ लॉर्ड महावीरा who was born in 540 and died in 468. So basically, Mahavira was preceded by 23 Tirthankaras. It means Lord Mahavira was a 24th Tirthankara. Tirthankara means Guru, like we have 10 Guru in Sikhism. Similarly, Lord Mahavira was 24th Guru of the Jainism. So Tirthankara basically are the teachers who guide men and women across the river of existence, means their guru who taught them how to live their life. So first Tirthankara was Rishabhdev. That was also a question of GK. 23rd was a Parshvanath and 24th was Lord Mahavira. So these are very important question for your competitive exams as well. So another thing, the birthplace of Lord Mahavira was Kundala Gram, Muzaffarpur district in present Bihar near Vaishali. Father name was Siddharth, Janathriya chief, belongs to Kshatriya class. And one thing you should know that Kshatriya was a class of the warrior. So mostly king and nobility basically in India belongs to the Kshatriya class. Her mother name was Trishala and she belonged to the Lichvi tribe. She was a Lichvi princess. And Yashoda wife, she was his wife and a later on he had daughter. And at the age of 30 he left home, and after 12 years he attained knowledge. Like up to 12 years he roamed from one place to another and then he got enlightenment. So and later on passed at the age of 72 at Pavapuri, Bihar. So he was born in Kundala Gram and died in Pavapuri. So this is the basic information about Lord Mahavira. So next one, so second one had the message of the Lord Mahavira. What was the message to the masses of the Lord Mahavira? So first, the message of Mahavira basically ideas of Jaina philosophy. What are the basic idols in the Jainism? So first one, the main teaching of the Mahavira are, what is the main teaching? The entire world is animated. And moreover, even stones, rocks and water have life. Another thing, no injury to living beings, especially to humans, animal, plants and insects. Another thing, the cycle of birth and rebirth is shaped through karmas. Asceticism and penance are required to free oneself from the cycle of karma. Asceticism means extreme bhakti, the passage of extreme difficulty. Like in Jain monks, generally you observe them, they always have some piece of cloth on their mouth, and moreover he never wear any kind of footwear. So they belong excessive asceticism and penance because they believe that by doing such kind of deeds they can attain nirvana, means peace. So this can be attained only by renouncing the world, means world ko renounce karke, tyag karke, wo sab kuch kar sakte hain. And monastic existence is a necessary condition of salvation. If someone want to attain salvation, if someone wants to attain, to merge with the God, then he definitely renounce the world and he should live in a isolation, means usse ekant mein rehna padta hai. So next is the message of Mahavira to the world. So first of all, what he said, he did not believe in the existence of God. He did not believe that God created and controlled the whole universe. He said it was all waste of time to recite the mantras or perform the sacrifices. From here, one thing is very clear to you people that Jainism is completely opposite to Hinduism. The three essentials Lord Mahavira said, good for life, the right faith, the right knowledge, the right action. So these three things are called three jewels or three ratnas. So next one, the message of the Mahavira. What is the message of the Mahavira? Basically, Jain monks and nuns must take five vows. पांच कस्में खानी पड़ती थी उन्हें. First one, to abstain from killing. अपने आप को लोगों को मारने से रोकना. To abstain from stealing, चोरी नहीं करनी. झूठ नहीं बोलना. To abstain from lying. To observe celibacy, एकांत में रहना. To abstain from possessing property, किसी भी तरीके की property नहीं रखनी. These are the five vows which generally Jain monks and nuns take before they get diksha. Diksha means जब वो Jainism के अंदर as a nun or monk enter होते हैं, it's called diksha. And next thing, the spread of Jainism. So here we are going to study how Jainism spread. So first of all, teaching of Mahavira was recorded by his disciple. So this was a basic method. But firstly, his disciple and disciples recorded all his teaching. And then they were in the form of firstly stories. And they appealed to the ordinary people to believe in the stories. Another thing, Jaina scholars basically produced a wealth of literature in a variety of language like Prakrit, Sanskrit and Tamil, and preserved in libraries attached to the temple so that many people can read those books gradually. Basically, Jainism spread to many parts of India because it attracted the lower class group of the people, as it attracted basically people by their common language which they easily can understood, like Prakrit, like Tamil. Another thing, many stone sculptures connected with the Jain traditions have been recorded for several sites. Another, Gautam Buddha, 563 to 483. So now the whole story of Jainism was over. You understand basic concept of Jainism. Now we are moving further to the Buddhism. So basically, Buddhism was founded by the Lord Buddha, also known as Gautam Buddha. And he had taken birth in Lumbini near Kapilvastu in Nepal in 563 BC. His father name was Shishodhana, and he was the king of the Kapilvastu Sakya family se wo belong karte the. And mother, Mahamaya, princess of Kosala, and she died within 1 week of his birth and cared by his mother's sister Gautami. So it means that Lord Buddha was grown up by his masi called Gautami, and at the age of 16 he married with the Yashodhara and gave birth to a son, Rahul. So this is a basic story about Lord Mahavira. So next one, Lord Gautam Buddha. Next thing, that Gautam Buddha basically was not interested in the married life. At the age of 29, he left home. It's also known as Mahaparithigya. Mahaparithigya means, उन्होंने 29 की एज में जब घर छोड़ा था, that thing was known as Mahaparithigya. And at the age of 35, he attained knowledge, great enlightenment. Enlightenment means he merged his soul with the soul of the God. And later on, he has given the first sermon, his first speech at Sarnath near the Banaras. And this is called Dharma Chakra Pravartana. Aapko question aa sakte hain exams ke andar, that what the event known when he left his home? It's Mahaparthigya. What the event known when he attained knowledge? It's called the Great Enlightenment. What the event known when he gave his first sermon? Dharam Chakra Pravartana. And later on, ही पास्ड इन 483 एट कुशीनगर नियर द उत्तर प्रदेश. सो नेक्स्ट द बुद्धा एंड द क्वेस्ट फॉर एनलाइटमेंट द लाइफ ऑफ बुद्धा. सो बेसिकली there are three traumatic incident which changed the life of the Buddha. It's very famous for the Lord Buddha that he suffered from the three things and later on he realized the reality of the world and renounced the world. First one, so basically Buddha was one of the most influential teacher of his time. Secondly, his message basically spread across the subcontinent and beyond through Central Asia, China, Korea, Japan, Sri Lanka, Myanmar, Thailand, Indonesia. So Buddhism was spread to all these regions. Another thing, Buddha was named Siddhartha at birth and was the son of the chief of Sakya clan, Sushodhana. He led to a sheltered upbringing. Usse unki badi achhi palan poshan kiya gaya tha. In the place detached from the harsh realities of life. Meaning that he had the silver spoon in his childhood. So he never faced the basic realities of the life. And later on, what happened with him? He undertook a journey into a city which was a turning point in his life. Once he went out of the city, then he observed that what happened in the world, what are the realities of the life. So here is a first. He was deeply anguished, pained when he saw an old man, a sick man, and a corpse means a dead body. It was at the moment that he realized that decay of human body was inevitable, meaning the human body ne ek din khatam hi ho jana hai. No one can deny this thing. To isko koi rok hi nahi sakta. This is inevitable. He saw a mendicant traveler who had come to terms with an old age disease and death and found peace. Soon after, Siddhartha left his place at the age of 29 in the search of truth. When he observed that this is a reality of the life, then he renounced the world and went to different places in search of the reality of the life, in search of the new questions. So look, here is a picture of the Bodhi tree at Sarnath where Lord Buddha got enlightenment and had given his first sermon. So, a traumatic incident that changed the life of the Buddha. First one, he explored many paths including bodily mortification. Matlab, unhone apni body ko bhi bahut zyada matlab hurt kiya. So that he can explore many new paths. He abandoned the extreme path. But later on, he abandoned that extreme path and meditated for several days and finally attained enlightenment at the age of 35. And came to be known as Buddha or the enlightened man. Meaning of Buddha is a enlightened one. Jiske andar ek roshni aa gayi ho. For the rest of his life, he taught Dhamma or the path of righteous living. Later on, he gave message to the people. He gave ideas to the people that how can they live their life peacefully. So what are the main teachings of the Buddhism? So here is a main teaching. Sabse pehle we are going to study the sources. So we have sources here, Sutta Pitaka. So these are the text of the Buddhism. Sutta Pitaka basically contains the teaching of the Buddha in the form of the stories, and few stories also describe the miraculous power of the Buddha and try to convince people through reason and persuasion rather through display of supernatural power. Means they convince the people by their stories with rightful words, with proper examples, not with the supernatural powers. So again, this is a picture of the book on the Buddha, Dhairya Gatha, poems of the first Buddhist women. So now there are the teachings of the Buddhism, Four Noble Truths, which he has given, also known as Arya Satya, Four Noble Truths of Life. First one, the world is full of sorrow and miseries. Desire is the cause of all the sorrows and miseries. It's true. when our desires will not complete or it left incomplete, then we had and we have many sorrows and miseries. Sorrowing can be ended only by the elimination of desire. By eliminating our desire, we can get relief from such kind of sorrows. When sorrows end, there is a perfect bliss. Fourth one, there must be a way to attain bliss and end desire. That was the noble Ashtang Margya or Eightfold Path. So these are the four noble truths given by the Lord Buddhism. So his main teaching, so first one, the world is a transient, aneka, world ek nahi hai. There are many worlds are available, constantly changing hai world. Soulless hai, as there is nothing permanent or eternal, kuch bhi cheez yahan pe permanent nahi hai. Within this transient world, sorrow is an instinct to human existence. Dukh hame isi wajah se hai, kyunki hum human hai. It is by following the middle path between sever penance and self-indulgence, apne aap ke andar hum indulge hoke, extreme ko adopt karke, bhakti karke, hum in sab cheezon se bahar nikal sakte hain. Human can rise above these worldly troubles. So these are the basic teachings, and later on he also gave the Ashtang Marg, Eightfold Path, also known as first one, that people have right view, people have right determination, right speech, right livelihood, right action, right exercise, right memory, and right meditation. This is a Eightfold Path given by Lord Buddhism. So we are going to do only the this one video, that main teachings of the Buddhism. Firstly, in the early forms of Buddhism, whether or not God existed was irrelevant. They also did not believe in this thing, that God was available. Buddha regarded the social world as a creation of humans rather than divine origin, thus advised kings and gyapatis to be humane and ethical. So he always advised people and kings that they should be humane and ethical. Buddhism also emphasizes literally the extinguish of the ego and desire, thus ends the suffering of those who renounce the world. When a person finishes ego and desire, then the suffering can be ended. So this is all about the Lord Buddha and his teachings. So we will do the another topics in the further video. Thank you.